Good morning, children. Children, I welcome you to today's discussion of science. And we are on to the chapter Matter and Our Surroundings. Now, see children, all around us, there is matter. Matter, we all know, is something which has weight and occupies space. So all around we see things jinke paas weight and they occupy space, right? Surrounding is what all is there around us, that is called surrounding, right? There are living things, non-living things, right? Where you are sitting, just have a look around you, you will find lots of things which have weight and occupying space, right? Air, food, stones, clouds, everything, even a small drop of water, it has a weight and occupies space. So everything is matter. Right, this is a very important line written here, that everything is matter, right? Okay, so man has been trying to understand what is their surrounding and all that. Now here there is a concept of pancha tattva which is there, right? Pancha tattva, air, earth, fire, sky and water. And it was believed that everything is made up of them, right? And ancient Greek philosophers also, they came up to that, right? So let us now come to physical nature of matter. See here, physical nature. So the first and foremost thing is matter is not complete. It is made up of particles. There are some small constituents which make up the matter. Now it is yet to be determined how small these particles are, what is this, or what is the smallest particle, smallest constituent of the matter, right? It is yet to be determined. But this size is basically very, very small, very, very small. Some experiments are there to show what is this, right? Or whatever it is done with potassium permanganate, right? So it can be concluded through this experiment that there must be some tiny, tiny particles which are there in the matter. Now these particles, they have some characteristic properties. First and foremost, particles of the matter must have space in between them, right? Must have space in this between them. Just observe when a lemonade maker puts a nimbu pani maker adds lemon to the solution, you will find small particles there, and you can see some gap. Now this gap is called interparticle space. This gap is called interparticle space, right? Okay, now these particles are constantly moving, and their movement is, and thus they, it can be interpreted that they possess what we call as kinetic energy, right? These matter, they possess what we call as kinetic energy. An increase in temperature increases the kinetic energy, right? Increase in temperature, it also increases the kinetic energy. And this motion of these particles is called as Brownian motion, right? This motion of these particles is termed as Brownian motion. Particles of matter attract each other, right? They attract each other. Okay, so we all know, see, right now things might be difficult for you, but for a moment just think about an atom. It's also a particle, constitutes matter, right? And everything will be clear to you, that what the forthcoming chapters will be, you will be dealing with. This is a prelude when we were, the concept of atom or molecule was not there. Everything was regarded to be matter and particle, right? Now there is a force which keeps these particles together. This force was termed as cohesive force or force of attraction, right? See here, this force was called as force of attraction, force of, and it varies from matter to matter. Okay, now states of matter. Matter exists in various states. In your course there are only three states, but very recently the scientists have come across with two more states to finally come to the point that matter exists in five states. But for you, only three are there. First is the solid state, then gaseous state. Three states are there. Now, let us move into the details of these states. Solid state, right? It has a definite shape, first of all, distinct boundaries and fixed volume. So these three are the basic criteria of a solid state. Definite shape, distinct boundaries and fixed volume, okay? They have negligible compressibility. You cannot compress it. Solids have a tendency to maintain their shape, right, and all that. Now we come to liquids and see on the same criteria. Have no fixed shape but have a fixed volume. They take up the shape of the container in which they are kept. Liquids can flow and can change their shape. Okay, so these are the criteria of a liquid. Now the gaseous state, right? So gaseous state, we all know that they neither have a definite shape nor size. They take up the shape of the container in which they can easily flow, they can easily move, and they are into random motion. So these are the basic criteria of the gaseous state. Okay, now there are some experiments to deal with. Can a matter change its state? Yes, it can. We have seen it also that in our houses, it's a very common thing that we keep water in the refrigerator and it gets turned into ice, or we keep water on the gas stove and it boils and the water evaporates. So water is liquid state, it gets converted into ice, which is solid state, and it vaporizes, which is the gaseous state. So matter changes its states. That is very aptly evident. And why it changes? Because there is a change in temperature, right? So the key point, key word here is change in temperature. If it increases, if the temperature increases, then the matter changes into gaseous state. And if the temperature cools down, the water becomes ice, and from liquid we get a solid, right? Now for water, it can be interpreted that the melting point. Now see, there is something written here that the melting point of a solid is an indication of the strength of the force of attraction between its particle. If the force of attraction is very high, it will melt at a very high temperature. If the force of attraction is very weak, it will melt at a very low temperature also. Now see, there is a chart given here. This is the chart of convertibility from solid to liquid. If we heat, solid changes to liquid and liquid changes to gas. If we cool, gas changes to liquid and liquid changes to solid state. Now there is a name given to all this. From solid to liquid, it is called melting. From liquid to gas, it is called vaporization. From gas to liquid, it is called what? From gas to liquid, it is called precipitation, right? And from liquid to solid, it is called freezing. And there is also one more, from gaseous to solid, it's called sublimation, like in camphor or kapoor. Okay, see here in this experiment, sublimation of ammonium chloride is being shown. Right, ammonium chloride is a solid, it will straight away get converted into vapors. Now just what I was saying is shown here, sublimation and everything, right? So you need to go through this. Now we come to evaporation. Evaporation, we all know that due to increase in heat, right, the liquid becomes vapor, and this process is called evaporation. And evaporation, what happens, and there is an increase in surface area, right? It's a surface phenomenon. From the surface, vapors arise, and it needs increase in
temperature, there is decrease in humidity, which facilitates evaporation, and increase in wind speed, because this vapor needs to be carried away. If the vapor is there in the air, then this vaporization will not occur. How does evaporation causes cooling? See, if evaporation will always need heat, this is very important thing to, and that is how our body gets cooled some many a times, right? During the heat also our body gets cooled. See, anything to evaporate, heat is needed. So suppose it is sweat, so sweat will absorb heat from inside our body, right? And if and evaporate. Now if the heat from inside our body is being used up, our body temperature lowers down, causing cooling. Okay, now see certain explanations, certain examples are there. Why should we wear cotton clothes in summer? Because what happens is we perspire more during summer, and then particles of the liquid gain energy from the surrounding. So, and this is facilitated by cotton. Cotton is a good absorber of water. It absorbs sweat and exposes to the atmosphere for easy evaporation. Right? Now, also cotton is a radiator of heat. Sorry, not radiator, reflector of heat. So it does not allow the outside heat to get into our body or absorb inside in the cloth. Why do we see water droplets on the surface of glass? Simply because due to the inner cooler temperature of the water, the vapor out in the outside air, it condenses and sticks there. Okay, now see, these are two more states. One is plasma and the other is Bose-Einstein condensate. Just I was referring to, these are the two other states, which are plasma is a state of super energetic and super excited particles, right? And then Bose-Einstein condensate, it has been given to the world by Indian Satyendranath Bose, and it was Einstein who predicted a new kind of state there. It's called Bose-Einstein condensate. So we have learned matter is made up of small particles. Matter exists in three states, solid, liquid and gas. The force of attraction between particles is maximum solid, intermediate in liquid and minimum in gaseous. The space between these particles and kinetic energy are minimum in case of solids, intermediate in liquid and maximum gases. And the arrangement of particles is most ordered in case of solid, then liquid and lastly gas. So let us stop here. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did in making it, and until we meet again, it's a goodbye.